a multi-sport talent, the first ever centurion from her country and the captain of Zimbabwe's national side. We have with us Marian Musonda in this episode of Beyond the Boundary, powered by Fantasy Akhada. So, my first question is kind of for yourself only. I was watching the video you did, Beyond the Boundary Live with Women's Cricket Zone. And that, you mentioned that you are, as a leader, your growth as a leader. So you were appointed captain in 2018 as this team. How do you see your personal growth as a captain in these years?
I can say it's been a good journey. It's been mixed with bad experiences and good experiences. And I hadn't been a captain, I think probably at school and maybe at basketball and maybe at provincial level as well. But to be given such a huge opportunity to lead people, I can say I've grown on the job, so to speak. I've learned a lot of things about captaincy itself, leading people, being a role model. So it comes with a lot of different facets and all need to be managed well. So I'm slowly learning. Sometimes I get it, sometimes I don't. And I just try to always learn from all the experiences I go through.
Also, these three sports, they're all team sports. They make you grow as a person and as a leader as well. So how do you think these sports influenced your cricket journey so far?
I can say probably two dimensions. The first one, the personal one, where being able to handle myself within the team, because the team is made up of different people coming from different walks of life. But you are there to focus on one goal and achieve one goal. So you might have to put your differences aside or your personal experiences aside to make sure that you work as a team and achieve one goal. So in that aspect, I learned to just be tolerable at times, to be patient with other people, and to have fun and to work together towards one goal. So I think in that regard, just being able to work with people and to be mature enough to put differences aside and go towards one goal.
Also, when you started as a captain in this year, the pandemic hit and with all many things, and unfortunately the Pakistan tour of Zimbabwe, which was historical in so many ways, that got cut short after playing few matches. And how hard was it for you as a new captain to this team to keep the group motivated?
It was difficult because we had also come from another disappointment a year ago, what we had gone through in Zimbabwe cricket, which really affected our team. And so for us to really psych up and be able to host Pakistan, for the first time, that match didn't go well the first game. And we were all looking forward to the second game. And as soon as we got to practice, after the first day, we've been told that the Pakistan team had to go back as a result of the pandemic and the flights and the logistics. And, so it's quite difficult because the team would be feeling like now we're going somewhere, we're working towards a goal, and then something like that happens. So it's all these are things that were beyond our control, to be honest. And that's how we just looked at it. Each time we then get another opportunity to play any other game, we need to give it our all. We need to keep trying our best because, due to the pandemic, anything can happen. So it was difficult to stay motivated, but, through discussion and just motivating each other, we find common ground to move forward as a team.
But then also you basically hit the clean sweep in the T20 World Cup Africa qualifiers after the Pakistan series, which was phenomenal performance. You scored half century, unbeaten half century. It was one of the amazing results for Team Zimbabwe. So from the lull of not being able to complete the Pakistan series to the highs of these phenomenal victory, how do you rate that performance of your team?
I think it just goes to show the potential that's there. You know, everything seems to be coming together. We just accept the fact that the highs and lows, especially now, they're going through a very low low. So we just take it a game at a time, to be honest, to say, okay, Pakistan, it was unfortunate, but we were able to host Ireland. Then we went to Botswana, we won that tournament. It means a lot to us. So we're refocusing now, focusing on the qualifier. So it's just a matter of, you know, always refocusing your attention to what's needed at the time and pouring all your energy into that. So that's what we are just learning. This is our, we played 3 games.
Yes.
And then here, this is our first game. So it's just been a couple of games, international games, you know, as a team. So we're giving ourselves a chance to just make sure that we are ready for qualifiers, just handling each game as it comes, to be honest.
Also, the T20 qualifier kind of showed that the kind of new young players you have in your side, like Josephine Nkomo, and all these players were able to put their stamp on this tournament. It was not just one player doing all the job. Every player, senior, junior, they kind of combined together. And looking ahead to the World Cup qualifier with all these young, talented players in your side, how do you see these players growing up through these kind of tournaments, big tournaments?
Yeah, I think one thing about competition, especially on big stages, is it's a confidence thing. And I was so happy to see some of these younger players, you know, coming to the party and putting the team in a winning position. You know, it only means that the future is very, very bright for them. You know, it means they can handle pressure at those big moments. And so that's one thing you can only ask for as a captain. It's not all the time that you'll be on song, but you know these players are always there to raise their hand to put the team in a good position. So for me, I'm impressed. It makes me feel a bit at ease to know that there are people around who can manage big games as well.
The first hurrah that was for Zimbabwe, which is the first victory, and it was a historical victory given what the team and the nation and such, the cricketing nation went through. But after the first ODI, Ireland kind of made the way through, and I think the coach after the series admitted that the batting was kind of the issue in the next two ODIs with Delaney and Gabby Lewis and Amy Hunter kind of going after the bowling, and Zimbabwe was not able to score runs. So how do you look at those remaining matches of the Ireland series?
I think most of it is experience. That's all there is. I think we can't underestimate a team that's been to the World Cup and a team that has played against the greatest teams, you know, in women's cricket. You can't just get there and think that it's going to be easy. And we are learning a lot from these bigger teams. We're learning a lot about, you know, occupying the crease and what it means and being patient on the crease. And everyone can see that, you know, experience is what's needed when you get to play these bigger teams, especially for now, looking ahead to the qualifiers. So I had an interview with one of the journalists, and I was mentioning the fact that we didn't have good starts either with the bat or with the ball. And, you know, cricket is about, you know, having good starts either way. You set the tone. If you take wickets or you bowl doubles, you create chances, you create pressure and wickets will come. If you were batting first, you need to occupy the crease. You need to keep your wickets in hand so that you can attack later on. And we just did not do that there. And I think it's still coming into the series as well. So it's something we're really looking at to say, hey guys, this is a real issue we need to sort out. We need good starts. We need to be disciplined enough to know what's being required at what time and how we respond to certain situations. So mainly for me, it's an experience thing. I'm hoping that we learn quick enough to be able to respond and to be able to think on our toes and to be able to just come up with the plan and go through with it. Yeah.
Also, your team got to play against another emerging side in Thailand. They've also played in the World Cup in Australia, T20 World Cup. How was the experience of playing against the side which is also emerging just like your side and has shown potential just like your side? So the competition part of it was fierce, it was visible. So how was the experience as a captain of one of those sides?
You see, you can, like I was saying, you can tell that this team has played bigger teams. There's just an urgency that they have. There's just a confidence that they have. And I think that's what bigger tournaments do. That's what, you know, going to the World Cup does. Even if you lose some matches at the World Cup, the fact that you've played against those bigger teams, you learn something. So then I could tell that they really learned something from the World Cup, you know, from the T20 World Cup, for them to then come back and compete against us. You could tell that there's just a slight change in the way they used to play and the way they're playing now, even the way they carry themselves. So this is the effect of, you know, being given the fighting for an opportunity to go to the World Cup, going there, playing against the bigger teams, learning something, and then coming back and applying it each time they play a game. So